Hi students, so in the previous session we have seen the structure of chromosome. So the chromosomes are the structures which are carrying the characters from one generation to the next generation, and the chromosomes are present in the nucleus of the cell, and at the time of cell division the chromatin is going to convert into the chromosomes. So chromosomes contains the genes, so which are the units of inheritance. That means they carry the characters of the parents to their young ones. So here in this lesson, the father of genetics, that is the Gregor John Mendel, he is going to prove that the characters which are present in the parents, they are going to transfer to their young ones, and some of the characters they are going to get the variation, and the characters which are appearing, or the gene which decides the appearance of an organism even in the presence of the alternative gene is called the dominant gene, and the gene which can decide the appearance of an organism only in the presence of another identical gene, that is called the recessive gene. So there are two types of genes are there, that is based on their dominancy and recessiveness, and the gene which is going to show its appearance in the organism, that is considered as the dominant gene, and the one more which is present in the organism but it is not going to show its appearance, it's not going to show itself, or it is not going to prove itself, its presence, so that is the recessive gene. So the dominant gene is represented by a capital letter, and the corresponding the recessive gene is represented by the small letter. So based on the dominancy and recessiveness, the heredity characters, how they are going to transfer and how they are going to show their appearance, and the basic concepts of the heredity are completely proved by the biology scientist, or the genetics, the father of genetics, that is the Gregor John Mendel. So Gregor John Mendel was the first scientist. He studied systematically about the inheritance and the transfer of characters from parents to their young ones. So John Gregor Mendel was only the first scientist who worked on the inheritance and the transfer of characters from the parents to their young ones. So here we can see the photo of John Gregor Mendel. He is known as the father of genetics, and he has proved by his experiments that the characters which are present in the parents, they are going to follow the next generation. And the characters which are present in the parents, maybe they are going to get little variation, but they are not going to get exact change. So, whatever the characters are present in the parents, so all are not going to copy in the young ones. But due to the combination of the mother's and father's chromosomes, so little bit changes are going to form. So the variations or the changes, whatever going to take place, it has a wide range of advantages for the organisms to be survive and for the continuation of the species in the changing environment. So by the two laws, that is the monohybrid law and the dihybrid law, or the law of segregation and law of independent assortment. So these are the two laws, that is the law of segregation is the first law and the law of independent assortment is the second law. So this is actually proposed by the father of genetics, that is John Gregor Mendel. So what are the things and what are the points given by the John Gregor Mendel by his laws, that we will study in the next session one by one. Thank you and have a nice day.